Okay, so let's move up to the top of this document. And start setting some of the basic formatting. Some of the things that the grad school tells you is that we need to set the margins appropriately. So I'm going to the Layout tab in Word. We're going to go down and set a custom margin. And their instructions are 1 inch top, bottom, right, and then 1.5 inches on the left. So we'll set that up. We're already double spaced. The grad school allows variation in that, but by and large, my experience, all of the theses that I've seen in our department have been double spaced, and that's a good standard to use. So if you haven't already, go ahead and double space your work. We're going to do some stuff with the headers here that's going to make it possible to create tables of contents that are clickable both within Word as well as when you create the PDF document that's going to carry over. This is a critical step, is to properly set these headings up, so I'm going to go through that in a little bit of detail. Before I do that, let's hit, I guess some of the easy stuff. So we want to use a consistent font throughout, and the standard generally is Times New Roman, so we're going to do that. So again, I'm going to do Control A to select everything in the entire document. Let's go up to the Home tab, and so we'll just select the Times New Roman 12-point font, and voila. Okay, so we think we've got that taken care of. Now, one of the challenges here, potentially, we'll have to go back and, I'll double check here in a minute. It's possible that if you already had some, italicized things in there and whatnot, we might have lost some of that that type of formatting. However, this took care of a lot of that, getting the right font on things. However, as if we go down to the EndNote incorporated bibliography, list of citations, it looks okay at this moment, but as soon as it goes through and it updates those, which it'll do on its own sometimes, but we can always go into EndNote and tell it to update citations of bibliography to force it to come through and kind of reconfigure that bibliography. We see that it defaults back to this other, font, whatever that is, that it's got pre-programmed into that EndNote thing. So after quite a bit of searching, I figured out how to handle this. There's a couple different ways to do this, but by far, I think the easiest way is to come in on this bibliography section here in EndNote, click on this little drop arrow right here to configure the bibliography, go to the Layout tab, and tell it, no, we don't want to use Calibri, we want to use a Times New Roman, and so we'll go down and find it, set the proper font size, keep it consistent throughout. The other thing that I would suggest that you do here is come in and add a single space in between your citations. You want to make sure, if it's not already pre-formatted, the Journal of Animal Science style should have taken care of this so that we've got these hanging indents, but set those at 1/2 inch if they weren't already, and hopefully click OK. As soon as I did that, it's going back and reformatting that bibliography for us, and boom. Okay, so now we've got, we've got the fonts, spacing, those kind of things at least are fixed. There's still probably going to be some things that we need to do with the citations. You need to pay attention to every detail on these things. So at some point, you're going to have to go through each citation and read it and make sure that it's following the appropriate capitalization order. A lot of these things, remember, are linked back to your EndNote library. So sometimes you, the easiest thing may be to go back to that library and fix, you know, typos and things that are misformatted and whatnot in that EndNote library that it's drawing these things from. Another trick I'm just going to go ahead and mention right now is to manually come in and fix these. Now, one of the problems, so let's say that, yeah, whatever, let's say that, you know, I found a typo in here, or an extra word or something. So let's just say that, you know, I make a change in the document itself. This is still linked to that EndNote bibliography. And so if we update it after making changes, it's going to revert back to the way that the citations showed up in the EndNote library. See, so as soon as I update those, and this will happen automatically, you'll go in and make some changes, and then you'll come back and say, oh, I thought I had changed that. And then, you know, it's back like it was. Well, that's what's going on. Okay, so the recommendation here is, as the very last thing, once you've got everything else done, if you have any editorial changes to make in here, come in and use this tool, Convert Citations and Bibliography. Convert them to unformatted citations. Now, this is going to force you to save a copy. Excuse me, that's not what I intended to do. And one of the problems with this, though, this is a good learning tool. Well, maybe this isn't too bad. I can just undo that in a single step. Sometimes when you make changes with this EndNote and you go to undo it, you'll see that there's a list of like 50 things there that you have to go through and undo. So fortunately, that wasn't one of those. What I intended to do was... oh, convert to plain text, not convert to unformatted. That was not what I wanted. I wanted to convert these to plain text. Again, don't do this until you've got everything else completed and you're ready to wrap up. It'll make a new copy, right? So you're not, all is not lost, regardless. So you'll have a backup copy. So if I say okay, it's going to ask, yeah, save copy. Put this in a new document, so I'm going to have to save this as a new document. But if we look and see what it did, those things are no longer linked. Okay, so it's just plain old text in there now, and I can come in and do whatever I want to do on, you know, fixing typos, whatever. So keep that in mind. But again, save that for the very last step. Okay, so I'm going to get rid of that, go back to our original document, and let's go back up to the top and start looking at how we want to handle headers and main headers, second headers, third headers, etc.